Vsauce! I'm Jake, and while playing the game The Witcher 3, I cut a lot of people in half, like a lot of people.
Let's end this.
Now, the character Geralt has superhuman strength, which might be why it's easy for him to bisect his enemies. But we see it so frequently in movies and video games. There are even two great TV trope pages that list numerous examples throughout fiction. And it got me thinking, is it possible in real life? With a sword, could you cut someone in half? The physics of successful flesh cutting is all about minimizing bulk flesh deformation, while exceeding absolute tensile and sheer strength. Now, flesh is easy to cut under pressure, but it also stretches and compacts, absorbing the blade's momentum. So, first things first, we need an exceedingly sharp sword if we want to be able to cut somebody in twain. However, not all swords are created equal. In Mark Myodownik's book, Stuff Matters, he talks about the process of forging a samurai sword. He mentions that by the 15th century, the sword steel made by the samurai were the best that had ever been created. They were made from a type of steel called tamahagani, which itself was made from volcanic black sand. Besides having an incredibly sharp and strong sword, you need an incredibly skilled person to wield it. Expert swordsmen were used in tamashigiri, the Japanese art of target test cutting. Today, people use special ruled mats to test out their blades. But in the 15th century, swords were rated by how many people it could cut in half in a single stroke. The number of bodies bisected was etched on the blade as a quality rating. Two full bisection was considered good, but there are swords in museums with ratings of 5. Mostly cadavers were used for testing, but sometimes the blade would fall on convicted criminals. To slice skin, you need a blade with an edge no wider than 100 microns, about the thickness of a piece of paper. So far, we have the three S's, strength, skill, and sharpness, but there is one more that'll help us determine if we could successfully cut someone in half. Stroke. Physicists at Harvard published a paper entitled Slicing Softly with Shear. If you've ever had to cut a piece of meat, you don't just push all your force onto the knife, unless you want to cut very ineffectively. What you do is press down on one end and bring the blade across. You want to carve, not dice. In the paper, they conclude that shearing minimizes the bulk deformation, squishing of flesh, before a fracture nucleates. You break cells apart. But here's the thing, we can use science to try and calculate cutting someone in half, but there's also a healthy dose of luck involved. Excuse me. Cutting through the flesh is the easy part. Where the trouble comes in is the spine. You'd have to strike the person right in the area below their lower rib and above their hip. Not a giant target, you'd have to deliver over 200 joules of energy to both the flesh and the spine, assuming a super sharp 10 micron edge. Watching Geralt's spinning bisection move, his 360 spin happens in less than half a second. That tells us that he's delivering around 170 joules through the blade. Less than needed, but actually just enough energy if he manages to strike through an intervertebral disc and miss bone. Geralt must be incredibly skilled or preternaturally fast. If we assume that the move is over in an almost impossible quarter of a second, then he delivers a healthy 680 joules and could probably cut three people in half in one move. So could a human do this? Well, Tamashigiri tells us yes, under special conditions. Probably those convicts and cadavers weren't moving too fast. In a real fight? Well, we just happen to have a master swordsman and an anatomically correct ballistics dummy to find out. So we were able to get all the way through the torso until hitting the spine directly, which we thought would give us trouble anyway. And also you could see in the footage how much momentum of the sword this ballistics gel was absorbing. It was insane. So let's try something else. As we found out, it takes more than just being an incredible swordsman or having an amazing weapon to be able to cut somebody in half. It also takes a lot of luck. Maybe next time, my friend. You're a little shorter than I remember you. And as always, thanks for watching.